For the Philippines, the country's security officials are proposing a new strategy to deal with China's aggression. Rafi Santos reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. slams the latest harassment of Philippine boats by Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea. He says the aggression only strengthens the government's determination to defend and protect the West Philippine Sea. Marcos asserts the Ayungin Shoal is within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone and any claim of sovereignty by other nations is contrary to international law. Manila's Foreign Affairs Department has summoned Chinese ambassador to the Philippines Juan Xiliang. The DFA also raising the possibility of expelling Huang from the country. Meanwhile, the Task Force for the West Philippine Sea is preparing a new strategy to counter China. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says they are just waiting for a go signal from the president.
The National Task Force West Philippine Sea has prepared a national strategy, a new national strategy for the West Philippine Sea, which does not only contain our military strategy, but also contains non-military strategies. And it's ready for presentation to the president. I hope we are given an opportunity to make that presentation this December so that if the president adopts this new strategy, this could possibly signal the change that you have been asking.
The international community rallying behind the Philippines. The U.S. State Department says the incident disregards Filipino safety and international laws. It also reaffirmed America's commitment to the mutual defense treaty between Washington and Manila. The European Union, meanwhile, calls the incident deeply troubling as it called for a peaceful and lawful resolution to the issue. Japan also standing with the Philippines. It says it opposes any actions that undermine peace and stability in the South China Sea. On Sunday, Chinese Coast Guard and Chinese militia vessels tried to block a Philippine resupply mission to BRP Sierra Madre in the Ayungin Shoal. The Philippine vessels were hit with water cannon. The bombardment damaged the engine of the ML Kalayaan, a civilian resupply vessel. It was towed by the BRP Sindangan. The BRP Cabra also sustained damage. This is the same ship hit by a Chinese maritime militia vessel last October. The supply boat Unaiza May 1 was also hit by a Chinese vessel. But the Unaiza May was able to reach BRP Sierra Madre. AFP Chief of Staff Romeo Browner Jr., together with AFP Western Command Chief Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos and other officials, were on board the Unaiza May 1. They were able to visit the troop stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre. Browner is the first AFP chief to visit Sierra Madre and see the condition of Philippine troops stationed there. The Philippine Coast Guard says many Chinese vessels were deployed to harass the resupply mission.
We were able to physically monitor 14 Chinese maritime militia and 22 Chinese maritime militia through AIS. That means they have deployed 36 Chinese maritime militia and 8 China Coast Guard vessels. So 36 plus 8, that's 44, and then 2 PLA Navy, that's 46.
Despite having its own water cannons, Tariela said the Philippine vessels did not retaliate to prevent an escalation of the situation. Despite Chinese harassment, authorities say their resupply mission was a success.
The regular RORI mission to BRP Sierra Madre was also a partial success, with UM-1 successfully reaching LS-57 and unloading supplies to the gallant Filipino troops stationed therein.
Rafi Santos, ABS-CBN News.
China files a counter-protest against the Philippines over their latest maritime encounter. Beijing claims the responsibility for what it called repeated emergencies in Scarborough Shoal lies with the Philippine side.
China once again urges the Philippine side to cease its violations and provocation at sea, to stop its unwarranted attacks and smears against China, and to refrain from acts that undermine peace and stability in the South China Sea. China will continue to take the necessary measures in accordance with its domestic law and international law to resolutely respond to any acts of infringement and provocation and firmly safeguard its territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests.